Hey, Pat, I heard it costs like $20,000 or $30,000 to start an Amazon business. I don't have that much money. Is that true?
Wrong.
That is absolutely
wrong.
Proved over and over again.
Wrong.
What is up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. In this video today, I'm going to be covering all of Amazon's fees, how much money you really need to start an Amazon FBA business. There's a lot of bad information out there, so I'm going to break down all of the fees, the expenses, how much money you will need to start. I will also be covering how to start an Amazon FBA business with a small budget, just like I did in my $1,000 experiment video where I launched a product with under $1,000, and I will actually be revealing that product in the next month, so keep an eye out for that. But let's get into the video. So the truth is, you need money to make money. You need money to start a business, but you don't need thousands and thousands of dollars. So like myself has proven and other students have launched with a small budget, you can start Amazon FBA with not that much money. But let me get into Amazon's fees so you can kind of see how much money you will actually need. All right, so first off, we are going to start off with the basic fees. These are the minimum fees that you will have to pay to sell on Amazon. So first off, the most basic fee is their monthly selling fee to have a professional plan on Amazon, and that is $39.99 per month. This gives you access to Amazon FBA, so Amazon will pack and ship your orders whenever you get a sale. You get the Prime badge on your listing, and it's called a professional selling plan. Now, when you first start out, you could downgrade your account to an individual plan, but the fee structure is a little different and your storage space is pretty limited, so that is why I've always been a professional seller. But you can start selling on Amazon and skip that $39.99 fee, especially when you're doing product research. All right, so let's get into the other fees that Amazon charges a new seller. So you have the referral fee, which is Amazon's fee for selling on Amazon, and they take 15% of your sale price. So what does that mean? If you sell a product on Amazon for $10, they are going to take $1.50 for their referral fee. That is their fee just so you could sell on their platform. They have access to millions of customers, so it's almost like a commission to Amazon. The next fee that we have is going to vary based on size and weight, but it's the fulfillment fee. This is the fee that they charge you to pack and ship your products to the customers. So obviously, the smaller the product, the more lightweight it is, the cheaper your fees are going to be. This is my cheapest FBA fee. It's like $3 and something cents. I'll put it right here. But the bigger the item, the larger the item, the heavier the item, the more those FBA fees are going to be. So that's why it's always important to use the Amazon FBA fee calculator. All you do is go on Google. It's a free tool by Amazon, and you can calculate your FBA fees. Now, the biggest factor in determining how much money you will need is based on the product that you're gonna sell. If you sell a really cheap product that costs around a dollar to make and it costs about 50 cents to ship per unit, then you don't need a big budget to start selling on Amazon. If you sell a large piece of furniture that costs $10 to manufacture and you order 500 of those, you will need a larger budget. So it all depends on the cost of the product that you are getting manufactured. Also, the size and the weight will determine the shipping fee from China directly to Amazon. So the bigger the package and the heavier it is, the more expensive it's going to be, which means you need a larger budget. But if you are buying a product for very cheap, it's a small product, 500 units could fit in one box, then your fees will be a lot less and your budget can be less as well. So for example, my $1,000 experiment, the product was very small and lightweight, so the fees are very low, and that is how I launched that product with a low budget. So just remember, it all depends on how many units you are ordering, how big the products are, and how heavy they are will determine the shipping and the FBA fees. Which leads us into the next fee, which is Amazon's storage fees. You have to pay them to store your inventory in their warehouses, and I'll put a chart right here. I think it's around 75 cents per cubic foot. So again, that's why I like to recommend small products. It takes up less space in the warehouse. And these fees will change during quarter four. I'll put another chart right here. But since sales increase during quarter four because of the holidays like Christmas, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, they charge you more for storage because people are selling more items and that space is in higher demand. So factoring in the storage fees when you're trying to decide your budget on your Amazon product is another important factor, because if you go with a large product like a piece of furniture, your storage fees every month are going to be very high. Another important factor in determining how much money you will need to sell on Amazon is how competitive the market is. If you are about to launch in a market where sellers have thousands of reviews, big brands are selling the product, and you are going to try to compete and rank your product on page one, then you're going to need a huge budget because you need to sell more to rank on page one. You are competing against people who have big budgets. So those bids on the keywords that you are going to be targeting in your advertisements on Amazon, the bids are going to be higher than a less competitive product. So I've seen people sell products in a very competitive market, and sometimes their bid on different keywords were up to $4 or $5 per click. That means you're spending about $4 or $5 every time someone clicks on your ad. And if you don't get a sale, that's going to be cutting into your profit margin. But if you launch a product in a less competitive market where the average reviews are around 100 to 200, then your bids are going to be less because there's not as many sellers, and it's going to be a lot easier to rank your product on page one. That's why I look for people on page one with low reviews, because I could tell how easy it is to rank the product on page one, and the bids are going to be a lot less to rank your product because it's not as competitive. Big brands aren't jacking up the bid prices on certain keywords, so you could save a lot of money advertising when you launch a less competitive product. But those are the basic fees that come with selling on Amazon. There are optional fees, which I will cover right now. So one of the additional fees is product photography. If you don't know Photoshop and you don't know how to use a camera, then I would recommend getting a product photographer. And this could cost anywhere from $50 on Fiverr up to $1,000 based on people getting models or how professional they are. If they have to come to your house or shoot on the beach, then it could be more pricey. I do my own photos using a light box in the camera that I'm using right now, but I also do know Photoshop, so I save money doing my own photos. The next is a trademark, which helps protect your brand. You do not need a trademark to sell on Amazon, but I filed for my own trademark. Back then, they didn't have the Amazon IP Accelerator program, and it was around $300 for my trademark. I did it myself, but Amazon does have an IP Accelerator program where you get an attorney through their services, and you get your trademark, the permission to sell on Amazon with brand registry a lot quicker, and that can cost anywhere from $800 to $1,500 depending on the law firm. But again, you don't need a trademark to sell on Amazon. Another fee is going to be your LLC or corporation if you decide to get an LLC or corporation, but you could sell on Amazon as an individual. It costs me around $400 through LegalZoom, but you do not need an LLC to sell on Amazon, so that is an optional fee. The next fee is designing your logo. Now, I did this myself because, again, I know how to use Photoshop. I made a very basic logo, but you could go on Fiverr and find logo designers for around $5 to $10, which is very inexpensive. But that is a basic breakdown of all of the fees that you're going to need to cover when you sell on Amazon. Some of those fees are optional, but it all depends on your budget. And the main thing is what type of product you decide to sell. So if you have a low budget, you're going to want to look into cheaper products to manufacture. You're going to start off with a smaller order, a less competitive market. But if you have a bigger budget, then you could launch those higher priced items. But in conclusion, don't let those big numbers scare you. Don't think that you need $20,000 or $40,000 to start a business on Amazon. You could always start small. You could try to find a supplier that offers a minimum order quantity of 50 or less. And also you can learn from me, from my YouTube videos, from my course, which is going to limit risk and mistakes, which can save you tons of money if you make a mistake that costs you thousands of dollars by ordering the wrong product, or you didn't do your research and find out that the fees were higher than what you're actually going to make, so then you're losing money. So it's always good to prevent risk and mistake by learning from someone else. Helium 10 also does have a pretty affordable course that comes with the software. All of my links are down below. Again, don't let a big number scare you. Don't believe the people that say you need $50,000 to start a private label business on Amazon. I've done it myself with under $1,000, as well as many of my students. They've started with a small budget, but it does cost money to make money, so don't think it's going to be free. That is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will be revealing my $1,000 experiment product so you could see like what it is and how I launched it with under $1,000. But in the meantime, check out my $1,000 experiment playlist. I also have another video on how to start Amazon FBA with a small budget. That is it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.